Welcome to the Manifestation Bay podcast. My name is Catherine Zinkina, and I'm a manifestation expert, master mindset coach, and multiple seven-figure entrepreneur. I'm obsessed with helping you achieve everything that you once thought was impossible. If you're looking to massively up-level your life, your finances, your relationships, your productivity and success, then you have come to the right place. My goal in this podcast is to help you see the infinite potential within yourself to be, do, and have anything that your heart desires. Think of this podcast as your weekly dose of mindset development to help you maximize who you are and where you're going. Leave it to me to provide you with the tools, the resources, the strategies, and teachings that you need to manifest a reality wilder than your wildest dreams. I know we're about to have so much fun together, so thank you so much for pushing play today, and now let's begin. Hello, gorgeous souls, and welcome back to the Manifestation Bay podcast. My name is Catherine Zinkina, and if you're a first-time listener, I just wanted to thank you for pushing play on this episode today. And if you are already a loyal listener, I just want to say that I appreciate you, and I'm so grateful for you choosing to continuously tune into the Manifestation Bay podcast. Because of you, I will keep bringing on the content for you and keep bringing on new episodes and new guests and new topics. And I just want to let you know that you are the one who inspires me to keep going, to never give up, and to keep sharing all of the lessons, all of the crazy lessons that I am learning on this journey called life. Today's a very special episode, and it's going to be a very ironic episode. And the reason why it's ironic is because I literally just canceled a podcast interview with one of my good friends. She was supposed to be interviewing me, and I texted her about an hour before we were supposed to go and push the record button. And I told her that there's absolutely no way that I can show up as my best self, which is so ironic because now I'm showing up on my own podcast episode, but it's mainly because, first of all, I believe that we are always our best selves and we're always doing the best that we can with the resources that we have. And we always, including myself, have this belief that we're supposed to be perfect in order to teach a lesson or to share our story, or we're supposed to be perfect in order to speak to people. And that's clearly untrue. And I guess what I'm doing here is I am challenging myself to release that perfectionism and release this idea that I always have to have my shit together in order to share a part of myself or share my journey or share my story or share a lesson that I know that we as human beings are all going through, and that what I'm sharing today is not unique, but it is not very commonly and often talked about in the spirituality, personal development, manifestation, law of attraction world. And this is what I'm talking about today, is the truth about doing the inner work. And I just don't see this talked about enough. And the reason why I don't see it talked about enough is because it's very freaking unsexy, okay? It is the human aspect of doing the work. And by work, I mean the internal work. I mean reorganizing your beliefs, eliminating limiting beliefs that no longer serve you, rewiring your, essentially your mind, rewiring your thoughts, rewiring your beliefs, how you see yourself, your identity, and all of that deep, deep, scary, scary stuff. And the reason why it's scary is because it's very uncomfortable and our egos do not like it whatsoever. And our egos also lead us to believe that when this is happening to us, when this is actually happening for us, that we are not normal and that we are imperfect and that we are bad people and that we're doing something wrong. And I'm here to record this podcast episode because I want to talk about this thing. This is kind of like my own healing process that I'm going through right now. And I know that I'm never the only one going through this, right? We are never alone in what we're going through. And so I'm sure that someone needs to hear this out there. I talk about this in my 12 Universal Laws Masterclass. I've talked about it inside of my academies, where I do share the deep processes and the deep work that I do on myself with my students. And I just know that someone out there right now is probably dealing with something similar. And I just want to put this podcast episode out there and share this lesson with you so that you know that you are completely normal, okay? So here is the issue that I see in this personal growth, personal development, manifestation, law of attraction world, which is a lot of people out there are very focused on surface level spiritual work. And the belief that everything is linear and the key to success is to just become high vibe, right? You hear this a lot. Just think positive thoughts. Just be high vibe and everything will fall into place. Just build your vision board. Just smear your affirmations all over your limiting beliefs and it will just magically change. And you're going to wake up the next morning as a millionaire and life will be perfect. Your dream ideal mate is going to show up in your bed tomorrow morning and you're going to open up your bank account and $100,000 has been deposited overnight. And you're going to walk out of your apartment and into your dream car because it has also appeared in your garage overnight. And that's just not how things work, right? That is very surface level spiritual work where we believe that things, that growth is going to be linear. And we are on this path or this journey to perfection. And one day with enough of this, enough affirmations and enough vision boards and enough candles and enough rituals and enough tarot card readings and oracle readings that we're gonna wake up and we're gonna be perfect. And we are reaching for perfection and we're reaching for this ideal of being happy, 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 happy every effing day, where the moment that we have a negative thought, it means that we did something wrong. There's an error in our minds. There's an error in our programming. We need to wipe it out. And if we don't wipe it out, then we're going to undo all of the work that we did before versus the actual truth and the actual deep, deep level spiritual work that I do myself and that I encourage my students to do, and I'm encouraging you to do, regardless of whether you're one of my students or not. I believe that if you're listening to my podcast, I see you as someone who is very hungry for knowledge, and I am so grateful that you're choosing to tune into what I have to say. I feel very, very honored and very blessed for that. So thank you so much for trusting me. The deep, deep, deep truth, the deep spiritual work, and the actual truth is that personal growth is actually freaking all over the place. It is circular. It is sometimes exponential, sometimes linear. Sometimes you're going to come back to right where you started because you have a lot of layers to work through. Okay. You can be all over the place with a general trend of moving upward towards enlightenment and conscious freedom. There's a general trend up, but there's going to be ups and downs because you have so many layers to you. And there are so many unconscious traumas that may have occurred in your childhood or in your past that you're going to be working through on a consistent basis. There's going to be a lot of lessons that you are here to learn where the learning just doesn't stop with a year's worth of reading self-help books, right? Or even going through something like the Rich Babe Academy or the Manifestation Babe Academy, where you do that actual deep, deep spiritual work, the deep, you know, working through the layers kind of work, the rewiring your entire subconscious mind so that you can create a more empowering reality. Even in that deep work, you might have to go through some ups and downs and some chaos. And this chaos is essentially what I've been dealing with this week. Very, very chaotic. Like my reality is just going crazy, okay? And the reason why this is occurring, and actually I learned this from a psychic back in 2016. So in 2016, I had a session with a psychic that my mom very generously shared with me. It's actually a psychic. I've talked about her before. She's amazing. Her name is Anna Galliers. You can find her online. I'm going to spell her last name for you. So if you can just Google her, you can come across her website and book a session with her. Highly recommend her if you're into that kind of thing. Her last name is G-A-L-L-I-E-R-S, Anna Galliers. And my mom actually watched a psychic television show where she literally found the psychic. She's a British woman, and the psychic show is actually Ukrainian. So I think she was one of the only English speakers on the show at the time. And my mom just fell in love with her. And I think she was like the semi-finalist or something, or the she got like second place. And my mom booked her and loved having a session with her. She's actually the one who predicted that Brennan would be my husband one day, because my mom booked a session with her literally the first week that I started dating Brennan. And she told me that. And I was like, what, mom? Like, it's very early. What are you talking about? And my mom just fell in love with Brennan from that point on, because I'm assuming it's because the psychic told her wonderful things about Brennan. And she just had like full trust with Brennan. And I was like, okay, let me book a session with, you know, especially with the progression of my relationship with Brennan. I was like, okay, the psychic totally knows what she's talking about. Let me book a session with her. And when I booked the session with her, the psychic told me that when I will move to Los Angeles, which was 3 or 4 months ahead of the session. So I haven't left for Los Angeles yet in 2016. I was just packing my stuff. I think it was like the beginning of the year. And she said, when you move to LA, you're going to have a completely different, and she was a little more vague, like obviously not so specific, but she was a little more vague when she was describing this. But it was, I mean, when I look back, it's very accurate. She was talking about how I was going to have a brand new website, how I was going to have a slightly different business model, how Los Angeles is really going to open up my energy, how I'm meant to be here, I'm meant to thrive here. Everything is going to be wonderful. I'm going to reach the levels of success that I desire, et cetera, et cetera. Like, painted this beautiful picture, right, of success for me and what my life is going to look like when I move to LA. So you bet your ass I was very excited to move to LA. And the thing that happened when I moved to Los Angeles, after doing a lot of inner work, that was like when I really started to go deep, was in 2016. Because I was determined to succeed and determined to change my reality and determined to master the law of attraction and manifestation and all the different laws involved with it. When I moved to LA, the very opposite happened. Guys, the very opposite happened. I went through so much chaos and so much going wrong and so much frustration and so much like, what the fuck? What the fuck moments, so many of them, where you guys know the story. I was living on my grandma's couch. Actually, if you're brand new, you probably don't know my story, so I shouldn't assume that, but I couldn't afford Los Angeles rent. I was living on my grandma's couch. I was essentially pushed to get a 9-to-5 job just so that I can afford, you know, my car, gas, food, you know, basic expenses. I had nowhere to go, nowhere to live, lived on my grandma's couch. And Manifestation Babe was actually a result of the breakthroughs that I had in my own life, proving to myself that manifestation is absolutely a real thing. And I was going to use it, and I was going to completely transform my life using manifestation. I was going to prove it to myself. And as a result, I created a business where I now help others prove it to themselves too. And in the midst of this chaos in 2016, I had another session with the psychic. I went back to her basically asking for clarity. Like, what do you mean everything's going to go well? Everything is going wrong, right? Why is everything going wrong? Where did I mess up? And I'm not going to lie, you guys, there are moments where I just wanted to give up. I was so frustrated. I spent so many nights on that couch just crying myself to sleep. And just begging for a breakthrough, begging for something to change. And I was so confused because I was doing my vision board. I was doing my visualization. I was doing my meditation. I was doing my affirmations. I was reading the damn books. I was taking the damn courses. I was investing in myself. And yet things were worse. WTF. So she's the one who taught me this lesson, and she is the one who has helped me up until this day, where I know that I'm going through the exact same thing right now, and you might be too. And I want to share with you why and my perspective of this, you know, in addition to her perspective, because I really want you to know that there is absolutely nothing wrong with you and that everything is happening for you. Everything is going in your favor. It's just that the human perspective, or the perspective through the ego, does not see it this way. And that doesn't mean that there's something wrong with you. It's just that from that 3D reality mold, right? From that very comfort zone, survivalistic mindset, which is where your ego is coming from. It's just here to keep you safe. It's just here to give you this body. It's just here to help you develop an identity as you move on in this experience of life, that your ego sees it as you doing something wrong when your higher self is so in alignment with the universe and you're going through exactly what you need to be going through. And she told me in that session when I was like, Anna, I need answers. What is wrong? What did I do? You know, why am I doing all the right things and yet everything in my reality is messed up? And she said, oh, Catherine, but don't you know, chaos means you're on the right path. Guys, I looked at her with the widest eyes, like, what do you mean? I thought that what she had just told me was the craziest thing I've ever heard, because I've never read this in a single law of attraction book. None of my self-help books talk about this, right? None of my, the courses that I was investing in at the time are not like the courses I invest in now. The courses I invest in now are serious courses, serious intensive programs, seminars, coaches. I mean, very high level stuff. Back then it was just whatever I can get my hands on. And of course we all have this, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. It's just, I was investing in just like some cheaper, lower level stuff. And that's okay, because we got to start somewhere. And I noticed that nobody was talking about that. And so it was the first time I ever heard that. And I was like, why is this the first time I've ever heard that? And it took me a couple days to process it. And especially when she said, Catherine, how can you expect things to, I don't remember exactly how she said it, but the metaphor that either she gave me or I thought of was, Catherine, when you buy a brand new car and you only have space for one car in your garage, how do you expect to move in the brand new car into the garage when the old one is still sitting there? You have to create space and you have to remove something and you have to break something down in your life in order to bring in the new. Your reality must break down in order to be rebuilt according to the brand new beliefs on a subconscious level that have been reorganized inside your mind. So now your reality is reorganizing itself, and you cannot expect things to go completely smoothly according to your idea of how it should go. Right? So the ego has this idea of like everything is linear and everything should just be high vibe and everything's going to be perfect. When actually, if you think about it, if you have a house, let's say you buy a property, okay? And on this property, there's an old house, but you really love the land. You love the land. You love how it has a view. You love the acreage. You love that it has space for your dog to run around, and you love that it has a pool, and you love everything about the land, but you just freaking hate the house. The house does not serve you, right? The house could be too small. It could be too old. It could be not your style, right? Compare this to like your reality, right? You could be living a reality right now that just isn't any longer serving you. And then let's say that you want to build a new house on the exact same property. So the surface level idea of the inner work basically is basically implying that for you to get your brand new house, you can just put the brand new house in place of the old house without breaking anything down, without doing any work, without removing the old house, without hiring an architect and a construction worker and everyone else who needs to build the house. Whereas in reality, we all know that we need to break down the old house in order to build the new house, right? Old reality must be broken down in order to create the new reality. That's just how it works. And that's where the chaos is, where from the outside perspective, you could see people tearing down that old house and you might freak out and be like, oh my God, what if I have nowhere to live? Oh my God, the old house is disappearing. What is going on? You know, it sounded great in theory, but all of a sudden I can't sleep outside. Where am I going to sleep? How am I going to do this? The old house is gone. What's going on here? And then with enough patience and with enough surrender, when we surrender to the reorganization process, the new house can come in and be built. And it's the exact house that you wanted, the exact amount of bedrooms, the exact amount of bathrooms, and it has the colors and the views and the windows and everything that you could ever want. But you can't have that brand new house without the old one getting torn down. And this is where so many people give up, you guys. It is really difficult. I will admit, it is very, very hard. I've shed so many tears this week. And the reason why I'm going through this, guys, is because I've been working with a coach for the last few months. And actually, 2019 has been just such a deep work year for me. Oh my goodness. The first third of the year, I was filled with health challenges. I would say like 10 to 15 podcast episodes ago, I talk about how I removed my breast implants because I finally realized that they were the source of a lot of my health issues. And so I had to go through that. And then the second third of the year, I'm experiencing what I would like to call another spiritual awakening. And the spiritual awakening has been messy, and it's resulted in so many days of me wondering, like, what am I doing? And I've spent probably more time in confusion than I have in clarity this year. But I know that confusion is not something bad. Confusion is the fact that I am on the brink of a breakthrough. That's what the confusion is. Confusion just means that you are experiencing something new and it's very uncertain. If you were so certain of everything going on, you wouldn't be confused. If you weren't on the brink of a breakthrough, you wouldn't be experiencing confusion. So confusion is part of that chaos and part of that reorganization process and you being on the right path, right? So I've been going through some deep work with my coach, and recently I hired a hypnotherapist to help me go even deeper because I'm like, you know what? I'm sensing some patterns, and I've known, you know, with the help of my coach and just my own self-awareness, I've known that there are still some deep, deep patterns from my childhood that are still playing out in the story of my life today. And I really wanted some help in figuring out, you know, how do I remove it? How do I get to the root of it? How do I change it? And I, you know, we can't do it all. Like, it's not like we're so close to our own minds and we're so close to our own memories and we're so close to our own beliefs that sometimes we don't even realize what is empowering us and what's disempowering us. And we can't always ourselves make the connection between the story of our lives that's playing out currently and where it stems from back in our childhood or where it stems from back in some distant memory back in the past that happened to us. And we don't always recognize a connection between the two. So I hired a professional to help me, and it was the most transformative session of my life. And I've really worked on some deep layers around unworthiness and unveiled some traumas that I really wasn't ready to deal with or wasn't ready to face up until this point. And because of that, I know that I have developed new subconscious beliefs. And the way that I now look at those memories that I worked through during the hypnotherapy session is like completely different than how I thought of them before the session. So I know that it worked because I can now look back at my past and some of the memories that were very traumatic for me, I look back and I actually laugh. Not in a way where I'm like defending, not in a self-defensive way, not in a way where I'm just, that's my coping mechanism, but like sincerely, it brings me joy. It actually makes me laugh. I have a completely different perspective of what happened. And it's just so mind-blowing and so amazing. And I've already experienced massive shifts in the last 2 days, just in the way that I think about certain things, like public speaking, like dealing with haters and dealing with trolls and dealing with unworthiness around my success and et cetera. But I'm also experiencing a complete reorganization of my reality. And everything is just fucking chaotic right now. And so many people give up at this point where they are like, I took the course, I read the book, I did the work, I hired the coach, and things got worse. And so they either blame the coach or they blame the course or they blame themselves for making a mistake or doing something wrong. And they think that what they're going through isn't normal. And this happens a lot actually inside of my academies. And I have told this to my students many, many times where you might be experiencing challenges immediately. Like it's like you set on this path to transform your money mindset and the universe might give you a challenge, a financial challenge that you must overcome because it's the universe pretty much testing you. How well did you learn your lesson? Did you actually transform that belief? Did you actually change that story? Or are you just saying that you did? And so oftentimes the universe and its glory intelligence will deliver you a challenge or deliver you an obstacle that you must overcome. And the moment that you overcome, it's like, hey, I'm a good student. I passed the lesson. Let's move on. And typically the universe stops giving you that lesson unless you go down another layer, right? Because the layers don't end. You're just going to keep going and unveiling so many layers, but it doesn't mean that you are just going in the cyclical pattern the entire time. You are also advancing in your life. You're also lifting your vibration. Guys, the key to raising your vibration is by eliminating all of the disempowering bullshit out of your aura, out of your vibration, out of your frequency. When you can let go of everything that no longer serves you and understand that you are already divinely perfect, and you can tell whatever story of your life that you want to tell and you can create whatever it is that you want, that's how you become high vibrational. It's not by smearing a ton of affirmations over your limiting beliefs. It's not by just ignoring everything that's going on and just plastering a vision board on top of it or just thinking positive thoughts, right? It is those things, but that is in addition to eliminating what no longer serves you. And a lot of my students, or actually not a lot, a few students have experienced situations in where they give up in the midst of their temporary chaos. While their subconscious mind reorganizes their new reality, they think that there's something wrong or that the academy made their life worse or that it didn't work, right? That it's not meant for them. That it was a stupid waste of time and a stupid waste of money, not realizing that they actually succeeded in the work. And the reason why they're experiencing chaos is because it was a success. And only those students, only the students who keep going and never give up and understand to their very, very core, and this is a belief that's going to serve you so well in this work, is everything is happening for me. My success is inevitable and I'm always on the right path. And even if I just want to break down and cry, which I have many, many times since Sunday, things are still happening for me. And even though I am confused, I am on the verge of a breakthrough. And when I get through this breakthrough, that is when I will have new insights. And when I have new insights, that's when I will have a new reality. Because new insights create new thoughts, which create new feelings, which create new beliefs, which create new actions, and new actions create new results. That is the process. And if you do not give up during the awakening process, you will come out on the other side, not only with a new reality, but also having had grown. You know, this is how we grow, you guys. We grow through the discomfort. We grow through the shit. We grow through the chaos. We grow through the confusion. If everything was supposed to be linear and beautiful and we're supposed to be perfect at the end of the journey, we're not going to grow. That's not true growth. True growth is the messy, messy, messy stuff. And not enough people talk about the messy stuff. There's very little people talk about the messy stuff. And I wish that more people will talk about it and more people would open up about it, because then we would all know that this is something that we can expect and that the inner work never stops. And you could think that you've already gone through something and you've worked through something and transformed something in your life, and then it shows up again 20 years later, or it shows up again the next year, or it shows up again through another lesson. And you are here, you know, I talk about life as this virtual reality game where you are the main player. You have your higher self as your ally. You have your ego as your main opponent. It's also one of your allies, but it's also something that you have to constantly overcome. It's going to be the part of you that continuously gives you challenges as you go through life. And the challenges are how you get to the next level, because there is no such thing as a game that's fun without challenges or fun without obstacles. And there is no game where you go on to the next level just because. You have to overcome something in order to get to the next level. And so these layers are how you get to the next level. You just unveil the next layer, work through something new, learn your lesson, move on to the next level. Again, you unveil something new, work through something, learn a lesson, and you move on to the next level. And at the same time, you are having fun the entire time, because games, you know, without fun, they're not really a game. So you're also supposed to experience joy and have fun and just play and create and design. Like, this is your life. Life is your game, and you get to be the main player. You get to be the hero. You get to create whatever it is that you want. But the moment that you allow a challenge to stop you, or confusion to stop you, or just because you don't know which path to take in the game to stop you, that's not the point. You're not supposed to let anything stop you. That's the real way to fail in this life, is to give up, okay? And the reason why I'm sharing this with you is because I want you to know that everything you're going through is completely normal. And I've been through a lot of random things and a lot of chaos, and you are imperfectly perfect. I'm imperfectly perfect, and life is unfolding in such a perfectly imperfect way, just like it was designed and meant to be. And I just want you to know that you're never alone, and we're all going through something at any given time. And the inner work is rarely easy, but it's always so worth it, because when you get better, life gets better. When you grow, life grows. When you let go of resistance, that's when you manifest your dream life. And it all occurs in the process. And even if you're going through the midst of a breakthrough in the midst of chaos, doesn't mean that you're going backwards. You're actually going forward. You're actually growing. You're actually on the verge of everything you could ever want. It is the process of your old home being torn down in order to create a brand new home. So stick with it. Find the joy in it. I know it's not always a joyful process, but this is really what happens when you do the inner work. And guys, this is the work, right? People think the work is building a business or going to a job or making money or gardening or doing some other, you know, laborious work. That's all physical work, but the hardest work, I would argue, is the emotional work and the mental work. Because the inner work is what creates the outer work, and the inner work is what inspires the outer work, and the inner work is what makes the outer work worth it. So yes, you still have to take action, right? Law of attraction plus law of action equals real life magic. Of course, there's going to be work involved. Of course, it's going to be action. But you want to be taking aligned, inspired action. And aligned, inspired action comes from getting the internal right, aligning yourself with your highest truth and your highest potential, listening to your greatest ally, which is your highest self, following your highest self, and knowing without a shadow of a doubt that your success is inevitable, you're always on the right path, and everything in this game of life is happening for you. And it's such a beautiful life that we get to live. It is a blessing. It is a privilege. It is an honor. We get to be here. So I want you to go through life with that attitude. I get to be here and I get to create whatever I want. And that, my friends, is how you build a life by design. That's how you build appreciation. That's how you go through gratitude. That's how you create massive breakthroughs in your life. And this, I have to admit, this episode has been so healing for me personally. It's such a great reminder for myself, and I hope it served you as a great reminder as well. Maybe you're hearing this for the first time. Maybe you've already known this and you've experienced this, and maybe you needed a reminder just like I did. Maybe I'm your Anna, where you're like, what? Chaos means I'm on the right path? I've never heard that before. I know, because no one's freaking talking about it. Or maybe I'm serving as a great reminder for you, where you can just know that you're not alone. Okay, you guys, it's been a bit of a deep episode. Not like all happy, 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 but that's life. Life has ups and downs, and with every down comes a great up. I believe that the best is yet to come. I believe that it's actually a phrase that's gotten me through a lot. It's given me so much hope and optimism in my life. It's such a cliche, and I'm sure like everyone's posted this quote at least once on their Instagram before, the best is yet to come. But the way I see it is that when I'm having a low moment or a quote unquote bad day, right, through my ego perspective, I always tell myself that the best is still yet to come. My happiest, most joyful moments are still yet to come. And even when things are going really, really well, I always tell myself, even in those moments, most people are like, oh, this is as good as it gets. Fuck that shit. I will always tell myself, see all this? Look around, Catherine. Look around at all of this magnificence. And yet the best, most joyful, most exciting moments are still yet to come. And that just gets me so high off life. And speaking of high off life, before I go, I have a very, 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 very special message for a listener on here, Jacqueline, from her boyfriend, Richie. I'm going to read this. This is from Richie. So I'm just going to read, quote unquote, exactly what Richie wants to tell Jacqueline today on the Manifestation Bay podcast. Jacqueline, from the first day we took that walk on the beach and I asked you to be my girlfriend, I knew you were the one. From graduating college to you starting your own business, I am so proud of everything you have accomplished and all of the amazing memories we have together. I promise to always take care of you as well as give you the best and happiest life you could ever have imagined. I know we will have an amazing life where we not only bring great joy to our lives, but impact the lives of so many others for the better. Let's take this journey and be teammates for life. Now, Richie has a question for you. I hope you say yes and live happily ever after, manifesting the best life together. How freaking cute is that? I'm telling you guys, with every low comes a very high high. And that's life, and that's the journey of life, and you get to create and manifest whatever it is that you want. And I hope you never see any low moment in your life as the end, as permanent. I hope you never see your current location as the final destination. I hope you know that there's going to be ups and downs, but it's so freaking worth it, okay? If you guys enjoy this episode, again, as always, tag me on Instagram, take a screenshot, let me know your aha moments, let me know what your breakthroughs are. I so appreciate you sharing it. Tag me on Instagram at Manifestation Babe. Let me know if this helped you. Let me know if this served you as a reminder or it's something you heard for the first time. And also, Jacqueline, because you're listening to this, let me know what your answer was to Richie. Definitely tag me on Instagram. Send me a DM, post on your stories, whatever you got to do, leave a comment, wherever. All right, you guys, I'm going to see you in the next episode. I have some really good stuff planned for the following month of podcast episodes. Really, really good stuff. Good stuff around money, good stuff around, obviously, hello, manifestation mindset and all that jazz. And yeah, I hope you have an amazing day, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Mwah, bye. Thank you so much for tuning into today's episode. If you absolutely loved what you heard today, be sure to share it with me by leaving a review on iTunes so that I can keep the good stuff coming your way. If you aren't already following me on social media, come soak up the extra inspiration on Instagram by following at ManifestationBabe or visiting my website at ManifestationBabe.com. I love and adore you so much and can't wait to connect with you in the next episode. In the meantime, go out there and manifest some magic.